Hello guys, we are back with our next lecture. In this lecture, let us go through the next question. Okay, so this question belongs to GATE CSE 2015. The question is, two processes X and Y need to access a critical section. Okay, critical section. Consider the following synchronization construct used in these processes. Okay, here var P, okay, and var Q are the shared variables and both are initialized to false. Okay, so var P and var Q are the shared variables and both of them are initialized to false. Okay, now they are asking which one of the following is always true. Okay, so let us start analyzing the question. The thing is, the process X and process Y. So most probably they will ask me about mutual exclusion, progress, deadlock and all those things. So anyway, let us try to analyze them and let us decide first and then let us check the options. Okay. Yes. Okay. So the initial values for both of them is false. Okay. So once a process X wants to execute, it will come inside and it will change its P. So var P equal to true. So this will be made as a true. Okay, so assume that here we are going to struck this thing, guys. So we are going to do context switching from here. Okay, so once we perform a context switching here, so this process will start executing, right? So let us assume here again we perform context switching. So basically we are converting this also to true. Okay, so once this particular thing has been done, okay, so just to give me a second, guys, is there any printing mistake or that is the given thing? Just to give me a second. Yeah, that's the given thing. Okay, so here the context switching has been given chance to this. Here there is no semicolon, guys, because most of the students are addicted for semicolon, right, in this particular topic. But in the examination he did not give any semicolon. Okay, so once I perform a context switch, what will happen? So it will start executing this statement. It is going to check whether var q double equal to true. If this value is true, you will go inside and you will execute, guys. Okay, so I will execute, but let us do a small thing. So now I am inside context, inside critical section, right? Yes. So now what I will do is, I will stop right here and I will give again chance to this Y. So what Y will do? While var P equal to true. Yes, true equal to true. This is also inside critical section now. Oh my God. So this is a huge blunder, right? Which is being done by this code. So basically inside critical section, process X and process Y are at the same time, guys. So hence mutual exclusion is a failed here, right? So mutual exclusion is a failed. So if mutual exclusion is only not there, then deadlock of it will be there, guys. Okay. So anyway, let us try to create that deadlock also. So don't worry. Okay. Yes. So now both of them are inside the critical section. So if this guy wants to go out, he will update that var P to false and he will leave. Okay. So he is going to leave by making that particular statement false. Okay. Okay. So we are going to change it to false, right? Yes. So VP will be made false. And if this is also executed, this will also be made false. Okay. So indirectly at the end, we are going to get the results. Okay. So let us check the options first. Let us try to eliminate some options. So option A says that the proposed solution prevents a deadlock, but fails to guarantee mutual exclusion. So this is okay for me for now. Moving on to option B. Option B says that the proposed solution guarantees mutual exclusion. Oh my God. No, I'm not happy with it. Similarly, option C says that the proposed solution guarantees mutual exclusion. This is also, I'm not satisfied, guys. Because both of these options are completely wrong. Because we are 100% clear that mutual exclusion is not possible, right? Yes. Moving on to option D. Option D says that the proposed solution fails to prevent a deadlock and fails to guarantee mutual exclusion. Okay, so these two options are left out. So now the only question is in between. Okay, so the only question is in between this deadlock concept, whether it is available or not. So what is the best thing to check it, guys? So try to make deadlock, guys. Somehow try to create that deadlock. So once it is made, you are in the safe zone, right? Yes. Okay. So here, this guy will make his own true, and while returning back, he will make his own false. Okay. So based on my understanding, I think there is no chance of deadlock, right? Because this guy is working on a variable p, and this guy is also working on the variable p. So basically, when he leaves, he makes it false. But here he works with q, and when they are checking their opposite variables. So there is no chance of deadlock, guys, because I tried multiple ways, but in any way there is no chance of deadlock. So with that, we can conclude that A is the correct answer. Got it? Yes. So it's a quite interesting and easy question, right?
Yes.
The only thing is, this code is completely new for us, right? Because they removed the semicolon, right? Yes. So most students, I think they might have taken that semicolon blindly and they have solved it, and they could end up with wrong answer, right? Yes. So please concentrate while solving these type of questions, guys. Okay?
Yes.
So I hope everyone got a clear idea with respect to this. So in the next lecture, let us continue with the next question. Thank you. Thanks for watching.
Like, share, and subscribe for more awesome videos like this. Thank you.